Some of America. Lowercase I, capital A, inshallah. Lame, that's what that is, lame. Please, stop with the Muslim abbreviations. Like, I love to read books, man. I read beautiful books about God, about religion, about Islam. I can't share them with my friends who are not Muslim. You know why? They'll just be confused because we don't bother to explain ourselves. They'll just be reading the book. And then the prophet, boom. Peanut butter? I'm not sure what. Doesn't explain it anywhere. And then Allah, sweet! That it's an abbreviation of a transliteration of an Arabic phrase. You're supposed to figure that out, you big dummy. And I got this email from this dude. He signed it, he didn't even sign his name at the end. You know what he signed? YBII. Anybody? Your brother in Islam. I thought it was from an African guy called Ibi. I just wrote him back like, not anymore. I just wrote N-A here to figure it out. But the truth is, we have to do a better job explaining ourselves. I've been thinking a lot about that. I'm going to tell you a little story. This is a true story that happened to me. I was flying home to Chicago from London, England. And I got to the airport. And I got to the gate. I do that thing we all do, like you start assessing the situation. If those people have babies, stay away from me. That guy is sneezing. That's bad news. I saw this dude across the gate. He was a middle-aged white guy, clean shaven, in a suit, just giving me dirty looks. Just, you know, you can send like negative energies. Like, I just started sending him like, so I had a little energy war at the gate. I was like, this guy's a jerk. I'm down. They called boarding first class. He got up. I was like, I knew it, jerk. We went on the plane. They called a boarding for the poor people. That's me. Now I gotta pass by this guy. He's sitting in first class. He's in 3D, okay? Seat 3D, left eye. I gotta pass by. I'm in 7C. Now when I have to pass by this guy, he's giving me that, I was like, when I sat down, keep an eye on this guy. I can see the back of his head over the seat. So I'm gonna keep an eye on this guy. He put me in a bad negative space. We took off. We're on the plane, about a half hour into the flight, I started putzing around with that little phone on the back of the seat. That is when I discovered a little known feature on the plane phone. The ability to call other seats. Let the games begin! 3D, send! Brr, 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 brr. And suddenly I saw his head pop up. And put yourself inside this guy's mind. His phone is ringing on a plane for no reason whatsoever. No explanation, no warning. Brr, brr, brr. It took like 15 rings before he figured out what's going on. Suddenly he's like, hello, hello. First time I heard his voice, I was like, British, I knew it, jerk. He goes, hello, hello, and then I hung up. That's the first thing you do when you prank call somebody. Gotta make sure the system works. Gotta regroup. Commit to the prank. You hear the little angel voice in your head like, don't do it. Shaitan, do it, do it. 3D, send. Brr, brr, brr. Hello, hello, who is this? And then I went, you're gonna die. Hung up. I even made a scary face and everything. Nobody could see me. It was just for my own enjoyment. And I hung up and I immediately felt three sensations right away. First of all, I was like, this is awesome. Second of all, I was like, I'm a horrible human being. And third of all, I was like, I could get arrested. What the hell am I doing? This is a horrible idea. I could go to prison. I could go to Guantanamo Bay due to my immaturity and childishness. I'm sort of freaking out a little bit. Now, what you don't know about me, before I became a comedian, I actually used to be an attorney. Surprise! Adjust your frames. So as a result of this background and training, the lawyer in me kicks in, and I was like, yo, I better have a defense prepared if they arrest me when we land on the other side of this flight. The last thing I need is to be caught unprepared. So I started going through my defenses, and that's when I realized I have a perfect defense. I'm like, you know, let them arrest me. I land in Chicago, FBI, CIA, PSA, take me into a locked room. And did you make a phone call on the plane? I'd be like, yes, I did. Did you call a man in 3D? I'd be like, yes, I did. Did you tell him he's gonna die? I'd be like, yes, I did. Why did you say that? Because it's true. He is gonna die. One day. I didn't stipulate a time frame. It's been a general observation. You're gonna die, he's gonna die, I'm gonna die, everybody's gonna die. As far as I'm concerned, I'm a good Samaritan. I saw a guy getting on a plane. He looked like he was in doubt about his own mortality. I just decided to make a friendly reminder. Hey, buddy, don't forget, party's gonna end one day, you're gonna die. Airtight defense, case dismissed. So I was feeling a little bit better. Thank you for applauding my evil plot. I'm out of time, so I'll leave you with this. The way the story ends is that I was still feeling bad about what I did, so I decided to do something about that. I took a nap. So I don't want to feel terrible for 6 hours, you know? And we landed in Chicago, I was still feeling bad. So when we got out of the plane, and we got out of the airport, we got out of security, because I'm not that stupid. When we were outside, I decided to go up to this guy, and I wanted to clear up what happened. You know, because he was probably freaking out. Like, technically, I was a psychological terrorist for about 7 hours. So I went up to this guy, I was like, hey, man, how you doing? He said, I'm fine, thank you very much, thank you. So how was the flight? He said, it was fine, thank you. I was thinking, liar. And I said, hey, I just want to tell you something. He said, what is it? And I said, you're gonna die. It took him about 4 or 5 seconds to process what was happening. And then he started laughing. He's like, it was you, mate. It was you totally called me. How did you call me on the plane? It was you. That was amazing. You totally called me, mate. And inside, I was like, thank God. And then we started talking. We had a wonderful conversation. And the way the story ends is basically, by the end of the whole exchange, I figured out he was just a regular dude. You know, he had a family, kids, and a job, and a life, and a mortgage, car, payments, and headaches, and stress. And he's just trying to get through life, just like me, right? And I could feel what he was doing to me at the airport, at the gate. He was sending me all his negative biases and his prejudices and negative energy, all that garbage in his heart. He was sending it to me. I could see that. What I couldn't see is that I was doing the same thing right back to him. All that anger and negativity, all the horrible things that white people have done to our people throughout human history, invading India and destroying things and slavery and colonialism and all that negative stuff that I carry around in my heart, I was projecting that onto this one white man. It's not fair. And that's when I realized in that moment, all of us do that to each other. And all we gotta do is stop. Thank you very much. God bless you all. Peace. Let's go, give it up one more time for